I welcome you all for this today's session on fundamentals of traffic flow. In this class, we will discuss about the directional design of early volume. Myself, Ashok Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand, Institute of Technology, Solapur. Learning outcomes of the today's session: at the end of the session, students will be able to calculate a directional design of early volume of the traffic. We know that traffic volume is expressed in daily volumes and hourly volumes. This daily volumes is used for design and planning purposes, but it doesn't consider any variations within the day. Neither the ADT nor the ADT, average daily traffic, indicate the variations in the traffic volume that occur on the hourly basis during the day. This ADT and ADT consider the variations within a year and within a month or within a week also, but it doesn't consider the variations in the hourly basis during the day. So specifically, high traffic volume that occur during the peak hour of the travel. So peak hour, it means where within a 1 hour you will be observing maximum number of the traffic flowing in a within a 1 hour, that we call as a peak hour. So for the traffic engineer, he has to balance adequate facilities to be given for this kind of the peak hour traffic also, or providing adequate level of service. So level of service, it means giving an proper speed, a capacity, a design of signal, all those things. Let us understand the peak hour volume. The hour with highest volume is referred as a peak hour volume. This peak hour within a day and within an hour in the day, you will be observing peak hour. It might be in the morning, busiest traffic hours in the morning, or busiest traffic in the evening also. So this is used for capacity analysis of the highways and also used for designing and operational purposes. And this reflects the hourly variation of your traffic within a day. This diagram, you can understand what is the peak hour. So the survey is conducted from morning to 12:30 a.m. To the next day of 12:30 a.m. So within this, the hour, the traffic between 7:30 or 9:30 will be observing the peak hours. Suppose that particular location, the capacity is maximally specified as 5,000 number of vehicles per hour. So it is almost reaching the capacity. In the evening hours, the capacity is, the peak hour is going beyond the capacity. It means here the possibility of having a congestion. If your facility is not able to cater this traffic, so this time there is a possibility of having a congestions, or there is a queue length formation at the this peak hour. So we need to consider these peak hours and design our facilities according to the our peak hour volume. Peak hour volume is generally stated as directional volume. So each direction of flow is counted separately. Suppose if you are the survey is conducted on both sides of the location, and if you are considering the there is no balance between the left side and right side traffic, you can calculate the peak hour volume direction wise also. So each direction we can calculate the separately. Highways and controls must be designed to adequately serve the peak hour traffic volume in the peak direction of flow. Yes. And this peak hour volumes, how to calculate this peak hour volumes? Whether we should take the highest hourly volumes, that is uneconomical. Should we take the lowest? That is also uneconomical. Should we take the average? That is inadequate. So now this peak hour is usually estimated from the projection of the ADT, that is average annual daily traffic. That term we are trying to refer as a DDHV, that is directional design hourly volume. Let us understand little bit more about this DDHV. So before we go into the DDHV, that is directional design hourly volume, let us understand the desired hourly volume. So this design hourly volume in both direction, adding both left side as well as right side traffic, this is used for the design. So that design hourly volume is taken typically 30th highest hourly volume. So this 30th highest volume lies between 10th or 50th highest hourly volume. Usually we take in between of 10th and 50th, we take 30th highest hourly volume as a design hourly volume. So design hourly volume multiplied by equals to k into ADT, where k is the proportion of daily traffic occurring during the peak hour expressed as a decimal. So ADT, you have AVT, ADT, and proportion of the ADTs, we need to find out this k factor considering the 30th highest hourly volume. So that k factor specified in terms of decimal multiplied by the ADT gives the DHV. Let us understand a little bit more about this 30th hourly highest hourly volume. Suppose in x axis I am taking the number of hours in 1 year with the traffic hours exceeding the shown over here. So within a year I am trying to take the highest traffic over here, which is shown in the exceeding the shown over here, and y axis I am taking the hourly traffic volume, that is percentage of ADT. Now I am drawing the line over here, 30th hourly volume. So from here it is getting the some decimal value, that is percentage of ADT, say here it is approximately 0.09 or 0.1 value. So 0.1 multiplied by the ADT, that gives the design hourly volume. So proportion of ADT is your k factor. So what is the principle behind going with the 30th hour? Why only 30th? Why should not 10th? Why should not 100? So all these things. So this 30th hourly volume, how we are trying to find out? If I take the highest hourly volumes in the year and put that in the descending order, highest hourly volume, suppose here in the January month or in the December month, you got a highest hourly volume is 1000 vehicles per hour. Again, in the next month, what is in the hourly volume? This might be lesser than this value. So lesser than this value. So just go on counting 1, 2, 3 like that. And at 30th value, what is the hourly volume that we are going to consider as the 30th hourly volume? So this 30th hourly volume indicates what? This represents the volume that is exceeded in only 29 hours of the year. It means 29 hours of the year, traffic is exceeding this value. Rest of the hourly volumes are lesser than this value. If I consider over here, if I take the 10th hourly volume, yes, it is exceeded only 9 times in the year, but what about the facility which you are giving? Facility will be required more. That is uneconomical. Again, in the 100 hourly volume, it is, if I take the 100 hour volume, it is lesser and more congestion at the particular location. So the K value which we usually take for urban location is 8 to 12% and 12 to 18% for a rural sections. So this is the principle behind a 30th hourly volume. Now you try to pass over here, the question here, if from the graph, if you take K10 lowest or K100 highest, what is the effect in the traffic stream? So pause for a while and try to think answer for this question. I hope you are able to give the answer for this question. As I told you in the previous slide, if I take the K10 over here, K10, the design hourly volumes comes higher. So only 9 hours you will be having congestion and rest hours will be having but it is goes for uneconomical. If I take K10 value, it comes 0.15 or 0.2. 0.2 multiplied by your ADT, the volume will be more. Design hourly volume will be more. But you are giving unnecessarily the more facility for that. If I take K100 value, it is something like 0.05. It means 99 hours of the year, it will be having a more congestion. So I should consider the 30th hourly volume, not more, not less. So if I take more lesser value, more congestion in the traffic stream. So because of that, we are taking the 30th hourly volume as the design hourly volume. Example, if the ADT is given as 3500 vehicles per day, and 30th hourly volume is given as 420, so find out the K factor. So K factor is design hourly volume by ADT. So design hourly volume is 420 vehicles per hour, and 3500 vehicles per day. So that gives you K factor is 12%. So now, if you have the traffic not balanced on the left side and the right side traffic. So you can calculate the directional design hourly volume also. So in the both side, if your traffic is not balanced, so this D factor is involved in calculating the directional design hourly factor. The rest will remain same, only we are adding the D factor. So these ADTs are converted to peak hour volume in the peak direction of flow. This referred as a directional design hourly volume. So again, K remains same. This is the daily traffic occurring during the peak hour in decimal. So typically we take the 30th as highest hourly volume, and D is the directional distribution factor. So how to find out the D? Suppose here in the left side it is given as 300 and right side it is 700. So D factor is 700 by total traffic, that gives you your D factor. And suppose from the table also we can calculate the, we can get the K factor and D factor depending upon the facility you are giving for rural, suburban, and in urban also. For a radial route as well as for a circumferential route, you can take the K factor and calculate the DDHV, that is directional design hourly factor. Another example for calculating the your directional design hourly volume, giving a ADT of 33,000 vehicles per day, and 16% is your K value, that is design hour is given as 16% of the ADT. And 65 by 35, that is the directional distribution is given. So usually we take the highest directional distribution, that is 65. So 0.65 multiplied by 0.16 into 33,000 gives you directional design hourly volume. These are the references I have used for presenting this presentation. Thank you.